With that, I'd like to introduce Michael Roizen, MD, has co-founded 12 companies, co-invented a drug approved by the FDA, and published 12 New York Times bestsellers, including four that hit number one. He is the first chief wellness officer at any major academic medical center, the Cleveland Clinic. He has published more than 170 peer-reviewed scientific papers, 100 chapters, 30 editorials, and four medical books, and received 13 U.S. patents.
Thank you. How did I get involved in this field, and why is it important that you get involved in it? You're the army that has to spread it. Dr. Oz and I can talk about it, and a whole bunch of other people can talk about it, and we love that. But you've got to spread it to the patients. And why is it important from the country standpoint? Well, in 1970, when I was a senior medical student, we had to take a course on medical school financing, and medical financing, not medical school financing. And we were spending in that era 7.2% of gross domestic product on health care. And we had up from 5.2% 10 years earlier. None of us wanted to take that course, obviously. But the economics professor who taught it said, if we keep going at this rate, we'll hit 12% in the year 2000, and we'll lose manufacturing jobs in the United States. And we said, why will we lose manufacturing jobs? And he said, because when the differential becomes 8%, manufacturing jobs move to the cheaper cost country. And he said, that happens with Mexico. We are three times as expensive as Mexico, so this will happen in the year 2000, that our manufacturing jobs will move to Mexico. We beat that. We made it in 12% in 1990, and our manufacturing jobs moved. We didn't know in 1970 about India, China, and Japan. All we knew was Mexico. Why are we three times as expensive or four times as expensive as India, China, Japan, and Mexico, or twice as expensive as Europe now? Because, and by the way, this gets really serious in the next 5 years. In the next 5 years, we were at 18.3% last year. We will go to 20 to 28%. When that differential is, if we hit 24%, that differential gets big enough that all the service industry jobs, the legal jobs, the teaching jobs, the education jobs, insurance jobs, et cetera, migrate. Because that's when that happens, assuming $80 a barrel oil. That is, all those other jobs move, which means we can't hit that point. We will either get rationing, because we can't have all of our jobs go away. We will either get rationing, meaning you will be told you can't do X, you can't repair the bottom back four teeth or take out molars or whatever it is anymore, just like we will be told that kidney transplants in anyone over the age of 57 are out, or you can't do X or Y. We will lose our freedoms if we hit that point. So we have two choices, which is either to do things rationally or to get rationing. And why we're so expensive compared to Europe, Mexico, India, China, and Japan is we have more disease. We have twice the chronic disease of developed Europe, 80% more hypertension, 110% more heart disease, 40% more type 2 diabetes, and 800% more stroke between 55 and 65, as they do. And at every age, we have much more than every one of our competitor for job countries. Even if you look at cancer, developed Europe, 5.4% between 55 and 65, we have 12.2%. Arthritis, 21.3% in Europe, 53.8% in America. The good news is that four factors cause 75% of our chronic disease. Four factors you get to control. They're tobacco, food choices and portion size, physical inactivity, and stress. Are those four factors absolutely controllable? Right, even Rocco did that in 1 month. And anyone here can do it, and you can teach any one of your patients to do it as well. The impact in 2007, when it was last studied, was 81% of hospital admissions are due to those four factors. 91% of all prescriptions, 76% of physician visits, at an average cost for everyone of $6,000. So you may not smoke, but you pay for every other smoker who is in your same state, because we do state-based insurance rates. And you may not be fat, but you pay for every fat guy or fat lady, because we share insurance rates. And that's why we're discompetitive for jobs. In fact, that's our only problem in our whole budget. This is the Medicare, this is the federal budget, as the Congressional Budget Office did it 3 months ago now. And you see that everything non-health, all non-health, goes down as a percentage of GDP from now for the next 70 years. There's only one thing that goes up, our health care costs. And Medicare now is at roughly 5.1% of GDP, and it gets to 19% if we don't do anything about it. And that's without any added-on programs or added-on benefits or new drugs, et cetera. We have only one problem in competitiveness in America. We have only one problem in our federal budget deficit. It is our health care costs, and we control it. Those four factors that you get to choose control it. And that's why our CEO 7 years ago said, yes, we have to be great at patient care. And yes, we have to be great at research and education, the three-legged stool of academic enterprises. But we also have to have something new called wellness. To show you how much he, I don't have that picture in there. Well, I'm not going to show you how much he believes in patient care.